Sir, finally, we had to see CM going personally inside the COVID wards, wearing the PPE kits and all, and discussing the situation with the patients and all. Your say on this?
No, there's a reason I'm saying what I'm CM has taken. CM is in charge now. At least it looks like. But it should be formally announced that CM is in charge of the health ministry. I look at it in that way. I will just give you one instance of yesterday's incident. Now, these people are still acting as if that it has become like a private hospital of theirs. They are the owners of the thing. Yesterday, there was a patient who came from Walpole. I am not, because it is just because I'm not talking about constituency part of it. Let me understand. And see, some people say that we are fighting and all. This is not we are not fighting over anything. I am just trying to get in to show the people basically what really is the fact and what is happening in a GMC. The people should know. Yesterday there was a patient who came from Walpole in the evening. He was given a red carpet was laid to him. A
Treatment.
pers carpet was laid to him. I will tell you how it is. There was a because beds were full. A patient was removed from the bed and made to sleep on the floor and put this patient there. So this is the priority. First of all, our Goans basically are sick. All our Goans, even people from Walpole and all the thing. But no one should be given priority over someone else. See, this is the more. There is no other humiliation than this. There is no humiliation in this thing. I think you should be inhuman basically do anything like that. He was made to sleep on the floor. First of all, that patient, whoever was shifted, he must have he must be there to save his life. And on top of that, it is another humiliation which is basically given a ill treatment by basically superseding someone else who was not even entitled. So this is what I'm trying to tell you. The hospital is basically be run for only a particular constituency. So there is no other constituency. There is only one constituency out of 40 constituencies which is functioning. Rest here, other people are not Goans. I look at it in that way. This is not an allegation. This is a fact. Here, your doctor's dean doesn't receive the call. Dean doesn't receive a call. There is a direct instruction from the health minister himself to the dean saying that oxygen only should be given when I tell you to give oxygen.
Direct from the husband.
Direct. I am telling. These are my direct allegations. So it is high time the chief minister takes a note. Chief minister basically is in action. But chief minister is in action, show that you are in action by holding that portfolio for yourself. I am saying, this is the time. Because you should be responsible. So tomorrow it should not be a two, there should not be a two, say, two system going on. Directions are coming from the secretary, CM is going in a medical listing. When the real person who should be there with the
PPK.
I see, I am not saying that a health minister or someone should be with the PP kit. What is the this thing? Most important thing is the duty of the health minister basically is not to guide the doctors. He should ask the doctors what you require. What my job is basically, and I am not here. So anyone may think that I am basically targeting. It is not targeting someone. It is the fact I am just trying to get into the knowledge of the people. That your people are basically dying there. These people have got no remorse whatsoever. Did one statement come from the health minister saying that as far as I am sorry for the deaths that has been on the thing, I grieved with your family. One statement has come. You go and see in other states. That is most important is that. I am telling the chief minister he should be more responsible in basically doing his job now. It is high time that the health ministry should be kept with the chief minister himself. Because you cannot have two fellows giving directions. It is high time.
They have been saying that why Babush is criticizing now.
Baba, it is not a question of criticizing now. I consider medical college one of the best. I have myself taken treatment in medical college. I still tell the people that the doctors are very good, the nurses, they really care for you. But these are the people who are creating problems. Our politicians are the people. Now that is the reason what I'm trying. There were so many health ministers, let us go. Dr. Willie was a health minister, there was Narvekar was a health minister, Dr. Amonkar was a health minister, then Babush was a health minister, then our Lakshminkant Parsekar was a health minister. You show me one health minister being Dr. Willie. Did he go to the hospital basically to guide the doctors or to see how the things are going on? See, it is more important is what is the one. You should sit in the secretary and basically doctors basically to tell you what is requirement. Your thing, your basically you should be a bridge between the government and the hospital for functioning is concerned. That is what you are saying. Yeah, you are directing the dean. This is the thing. Then you forget, remove the dean. Make you Dr. Rane, make him the dean. No, I am upset because our people are dying. Yesterday there are 3 deaths in Taligaon constituency and another 4 deaths in Panjim constituency. Our people are dying and it is a sad that we cannot do anything. See, people, some people may say, why we are not fighting. I am not here to fight. I am just trying to tell the chief minister basically to take responsibility because things are going out of hand and this fellow cannot handle. Now I believe he has made some statement saying that court should monitor this. So say, Baba, the leader is a fellow who should say, Baba, I have been defeated. Not my people. Doctors have not been defeated. Doctors are doing their level best. Today, everyone, as I said last time also, if today everyone is coming back home, they should thank the doctors and they should thank the nurses. Because of them, you have reached home to your dear and loved ones. None of them, because of these people. These are the people who have created a mess. Now, Chief Minister is trying to get things in order. So, get the things in order properly. And let there be one person who is in charge.
Do you totally blame the health minister? Because they have been saying that if we had done everything properly, set up,
No. See, now if you go to see, as I said earlier also when I said, this virus basically started from wherever, China, wherever it came. It came to India only in the month of March, some February, March. It came. So that's the time actually there was no remedy, no one knew what this virus was all about. Kits were not available, then vaccine was not available. Now then they say that the second wave had come after in other countries. We were sleeping. Health minister makes a statement, 200, 300 people will die. That means you were not prepared. I am just trying to tell you how come you came to know that 200 people would die. What was the thing? Who has given you this figure of 200, 300 people to die? That means you are not prepared with your hospitals, no? So you should say that you should have been prepared much before, saying that, looking at that, you are a fellow who has been roaming around the world. You know what is happening around. You are not an ignorant fellow. You have been you know what is happening around the world. So it is, as a health minister, it is your responsibility. I look at it that way. So whom should I make the death? These people are, today people are dying. Who should be responsible? When for they are dying for what? Because of lack of oxygen and all the other things which are not available. So it is not that you should stock yourself well.
AK Sarjan, the owner, scoop oxygen, I mean, oxygen power. Inga lok bo mata oxygen power. Where it is?
See, now where oxygen is going, that only they know. Now that God knows, and then the scoop fellow knows, and then the minister knows from where they're sitting. As the chief minister said, 10 years was given to him, by him only in earlier Mr. Dikambar Kamath's government. And it has been back again renewed by him only to give one thing, basically a monopoly to one person. See, I don't have any much knowledge as far as these things are concerned, so I will not just talk on top of my head.
No, but at the moment, oxygen is the main issue.
Oxygen, I mean, today operations cannot take place.
Correct.
Today operations were cancelled. I am telling you, today operations were different. Other operations were cancelled in the hospital because of lack of oxygen. There were no oxygen till today.
You are also part of this.
I am part of the system. That's the reason I am feeling sorry, no? These people are not even receiving the calls here. Your health minister doesn't receive calls. This fellow doesn't, dean doesn't receive calls. So there should be a proper management at least, no?
So if...
See, whoever the people are calling off, whoever MLA is calling is not calling you for a party. He is basically trying to get into your notice, but this is what is happening. We want you to basically correct yourself. Admit it, that yes, I have failed.
So do you feel it is a sorry state that you being a part of the government also, you cannot, you are selfless to help people?
That's the reason I am saying no. See, whatever we can do, whatever way we can help, we are helping. I am not here to tell this way I am helping or that way I am helping. I always believe when you help a person, a right hand should not know what the left hand is doing. That is called help. You cannot help people by humiliating people, showing that I am helping. Most important thing, this is a need of our. What is the disease? Ultimately, it is the life. Your near dear ones are losing in front of your eyes. And you can do nothing about it. They feel after the people feel, okay, MLAs can be helped. See, doctors are the right people. Doctors are doing their level best. But doctors are also basically, if there is interference from ministries, from ministers and all, do this, do that, do basically, this particular person should be treated this way, that fellow should not be cared for, this my constituency should be given more priority, and that constituency leave it at the side. We are all Goans. A Goan is dying every day. We are not counting which constituency people are dying, but Goans are dying. So let us not have a priority over this particular constituency just because you are the health minister.
Do you also feel that?
You are not a health minister basically for Walpole constituency. You are health minister for Goa.
Do you feel there are scams like ventilator, oxygen scams could be?
See,
there?
I am not worried about scams and all. That is not my problem. That is chief minister. That I feel best as if court should monitor what is really happened in GMC. Even I would say. Actually, a CBI inquiry should be this. At least I am waiting for chief minister basically to call for a meeting of MLAs and MLAs. And there I will basically demand that a CBI inquiry should be held in the health in the basically GMC and the health department.
What has gone on?
Everything. See, there is no smoke without fire. Somewhere something must have caught. But don't play with the lives of the people here. This is the least what you can do.
Is Babu skipping a wait and watch game on all this?
I am not giving a wait and watch. I am speaking out, no. And so are so many MLAs who are feeling. So many MLAs are calling me and saying, hey, whatever you spoke, it was right. But what the problem is with the other MLAs about the one, they don't want to basically be, to have this thing tomorrow, yes. Vindictive attitude. Because this fellow has got that tendency of having a vindictive attitude towards everyone. So it is high time you mend your ways. And it is just a clear message for me, for the health ministry.
If it is not corrected now, how long? Because 50s, 57, 64, that's Zaita every day.
So that is the reason what I am trying to say, you know. One person should be in charge, it is the chief minister who should be in charge. Let the chief minister say, yes, I am in charge now. Then we can question the chief minister. I am questioning the health minister because he was in charge. This fellow, CM is going to the JMC with the PPE kit while the health minister is sitting in his office and giving statements. See, bad mouthing the chief minister doesn't help you. You have failed, is my clear message.
Do you feel that criticizing chief minister is not the way, because he has been doing enough?
Baba, see, listen to me. I believe the chief minister is the head. Rest portfolios basically has been distributed to all the other 12 or 11 ministers who are there. Different people have been given their charge. And this fellow was more dominant where his charge is concerned. Because you could see him every day roaming around in medical college. So it is when the thing basically went out of control, that is the time chief minister intervened. No? And all these lies basically, suppose what he had claimed, 200 people would die, 300 people would die. So now you say that because chief minister intervened, that is the reason that has basically been reduced. I can at least make that comment. So you have failed.
Totally.
While the chief minister is doing his level best, from where it has fallen, he's just picking up. But unnecessary, because of your thing, the chief minister is basically to be blamed.
So oxygen acha ani ul lele kitha hapo the paristhiti adhin situation you know.
Are I am just nothing. Oxygen thing is not come to the real requirement. As I told you today also, at least six operations has been cancelled because of lack of oxygen. And government basically should come out with a white paper saying what is the real requirement of the GMC, whether this is available or not available. I think people of Goa has got a right to know what is happening and why their loved and dear and near ones are dying. People need to know. It is high time, it is the government, it is the responsibility of the government to tell the people why their family members have died.
So finally, when you would you ask the government CM to call up this urgent?
I have already written a letter to the chief minister to call for a meeting of all the MLAs, because this fellow should be taken to task there. And I want to know the views of all the other MLAs What is their view on this?